Hi guys, we're back for our last story of the week. Last time we talked about the digestive system and how it takes your food on a journey through your body. Today, we're going to learn the names of the organs involved in the excretory system.
Humans are exposed to lots of toxins or poisons in the environment. Your body may take in toxins through the air or through the food that you eat. If these toxins hang around in your body too long, they may become toxic or poisonous to you. The amazing human body has ways of getting rid of these toxins before they become harmful. The last time we met, you learned how your digestive system works to process food into usable nutrients, separating the nutrients from the sometimes toxic waste materials. At the end of the digestive process, some food is not completely broken down by the intestines. This leftover solid waste, called feces, is pushed out of your body at the end of the digestive tract. Bowel movements contain your body's solid wastes. But what happens to your body's liquid waste? Where does it go? Some waste leaves your body through your skin. Other waste is processed through a system like the digestive system. Just as the digestive system processes solid waste, there is a system that processes liquid waste. It is called the excretory system. To excrete means to expel or get rid of something that is not needed. Toxins or poisons are definitely not needed in your body.
Let's begin by talking about the liquid waste that leaves the body through your skin. We call it sweat. What is another name for sweat? It is also called perspiration. You already know that your skin is the largest body organ. It covers your entire body surface. Sweat glands below the surface of the skin help rid the body of waste through perspiration. When you perspire, water, salt, and other waste flows out through these microscopic sweat glands. So microscopic means really small, so we're not able to see them. They are all excreted from all parts of your body. If you do not bathe for a while, you can begin to smell this waste as it builds up on the surface of your skin. The body's main liquid waste is urine. Urine is cleaner than spit. Unlike the saliva in your mouth, urine contains no bacteria. It is about 96% water and 4% waste. This means that if urine were divided into 100 parts, 96 parts would be water and only 4 parts would be waste. Like feces, urine passes through several different organs as it makes its journey through your body. Today, we will take a look at the organs that are part of the excretory system.
The kidneys are the primary organs of excretion. Everybody stand up for just a minute so that you know where your kidneys are located. Let your arms hang by your sides. Your kidneys are in line with your elbows, at your back, just above your waist. Reach around and place your hands just above your waist on either side of your backbone. Your two kidneys hang near your spine, one on either side of your backbone in the middle of your back. Your bottom ribs and layers of fat protect the kidneys. Now you have a pretty good idea of where your kidneys live. So let's see how they work. Arteries or muscular tubes carry blood from other parts of your body to your kidneys. These two dark red bean-shaped organs act like washing machines for your blood, cleaning it of waste and toxins. As blood flows to your body cells, it passes through the kidneys where millions of tiny microscopic filter tubes capture the waste products and excess or extra water.
Think of a kitchen strainer or a sieve. Have you ever seen cooked pasta poured into a strainer? The liquid flows through and the strainer catches the pasta. Your kidneys act a little like the kitchen strainer. They filter or separate the liquid waste from the blood. Clean blood travels to your body's cells, while the liquid waste, called urine, is collected in each kidney.
Urine drains out of both kidneys through two tubes called ureters. Did I say that right, ladies? Ureters?
Yeah, I think
The ureters lead from the kidneys to your urinary bladder. The bladder is a muscular storage bag located in the lower part of your abdomen, which is below your waist. When it gets full, we can feel it. This stretchy sac-like muscle stores urine. It is a little like a water balloon with three openings. The two ureters that connect to the kidneys and a third opening at the other end of the bladder called the urethra. As urine passes into the bladder through the ureters, the wall stretches and the rubbery balloon begins to fill. Nerve endings in the muscular bladder wall send signals to the brain that the bladder is full and about to burst. That's when you know it's time to urinate. Urine passes out of your body through the urethra, the tube at the bottom of the bladder. This is a voluntary muscle, meaning that you are able to control its opening and closing, but you need to listen to your brain when it tells you that it's time to go to the bathroom.
In addition to preparing liquid waste for removal from the body, the kidneys also regulate or control the amount of salt and nutrients in the blood. They help to maintain a state of balance in the body. By controlling the amount of water your body loses, balancing the amount of water excreted with the amount of water kept in the body. Remember, excreted means to be taken out. If you have too much water in the body, you may feel bloated or swollen. If there is too little water in the body, you may become dehydrated or dried out. Dehydration can cause serious damage to your body. That is why it's important to drink lots of water, never letting your body dry out. Let's name all the different parts of the excretory system. The excretory system is made up of the kidneys, the bladder, the two tubes that connect them, called the ureters, and the urethra, the final tube in the process. It may appear less complicated than the digestive system, but it is just as important for filtering the blood and helping your body get rid of toxic substances. You probably know that liquid waste is excreted from your body a bit more frequently than solid waste. That's because it does not stay in the bladder as long as solid waste stays in the rectum.
We've been talking a lot about getting rid of the body's waste, but along the way, you have learned that the body turns a lot of the food that you eat into nourishment and provides your body with the energy that it needs to grow and repair itself. What are the good parts that are carried through your blood and stored in your body called? That's nutrients. Next time, we'll find out just exactly what nutrients are and what you can do to make sure that you are getting enough of them. See you next time. Until then, make sure you listen to your body and respond when it sends you messages. That's really important to maintaining good health. Boys and girls, thank you for finishing up your stories this week. Today, you're just going to write about the organs that are involved in the excretory system. Remember, there are two main organs involved, so make sure you get those in your writing. Bye, we'll see you next time.
Bye.
All right.